Hey guys, Caleb Wisted from Hooked Up Wisconsin here. Today I'm going to share with you 6 tips on how to improve your goose field hunting. We've been hunting geese here in Northwest Wisconsin for almost 25 years. I guided for them for 3 years, and over that period of time we've just picked up a lot of little tips and tricks and things that help us basically improve our odds in the field. It's just small little tweaks and different things when you're goose hunting that seem to make the difference between an awesome hunt and a mediocre hunt. So let's get into it. Tip number one, starting with scouting. Scouting is key if you want a good goose hunt. Obviously, lots of guys know you've got to scout to find the birds and find what field they're feeding in. But you also have to find out exactly where in that field they're feeding the day before. Whether it's in the evening before a morning hunt or a morning before an evening hunt, you want to be there watching those birds, making sure you see where they're going, you see where they're landing in the field, kind of where they're feeding, so that you can set up in that same area the next day. That's a key to getting those birds to land in your spread and not somewhere else in the field. If you've got kind of geese in a couple different fields, you want to make sure that your field that you set up in is the first one they see as they come off of that roost. So if you know where they're roosting and you've got geese kind of spread out around, just get in the first field that you can that they've been in. That way you can be sure that when the geese come off the roost, they're gonna come up, they're gonna see your spread before they get to any of the other fields, and you're gonna be the first birds on the ground that they see. All right, tip number two, weather is everything. You need to pay attention to the weather. Sometimes, you know, guys like me, I work all week. I can only hunt maybe 2 or 3 days out of the week. So I don't get to pick which days that I get to hunt. If you can, it's best to pick cloudy, rainy, foggy, windy mornings. I mean, as waterfowlers, we all know that's the weather you want. It just makes the birds fly lower. It makes them kind of less wary. They tend to not circle as much and look below them. And they tend to come right into the spread in those conditions. So if you can plan your hunt, that's what you want to do, is hunt those conditions. If not, you know, if you've got a clear, calm, still morning, you want to try and add as much motion to the decoys as you can. The geese just are less smart, so to speak, when you can get them on those nasty weather days. So tip number three is to hunt in the evening once in a while. We've done some evening hunts. You know, if it's cloudy and rainy, they're often going to fly out super early and you can't get on an evening hunt because they're going to come out at noon. But on a clear day, they're typically not going to come out until the last couple hours of daylight, and you can get set up, you know, after work or whatever, and get there and set up before the geese come out to the field. The one thing you got to do on an evening hunt is it's going to be light and they are going to see really well, so you have to hide as well as possible. Find a drainage ditch, find something that you can hide in, and they're gonna not be able to see you just laying out in the field, because in those super light, you know, visible conditions, they can pick out blinds really well. So, but don't be afraid to try it. We've had some great afternoon, evening hunts. Wind seems to really help. If you can get some good wind, it kind of makes them have to come into your spread the way you want them to. And you can often direct their eyes away from the blinds, just from the angle they got to come in at. But yeah, it can be a really fun time, and it gets you an extra, you know, an extra hunt in sometimes when you might only get a couple in on a week or a weekend. It can be really fun for kids too. You don't have to get them up super early. So yeah, go ahead and try an evening hunt if they're legal where you hunt, and I think you'll enjoy it. All right, tip number four. Decoys. One thing that we'll do with our decoys, if we're in a bare open field, don't be afraid to pile the decoys on the blinds. Like, just put a big black mass of decoys right where your blinds go and bury the blinds in decoys. This has worked for us countless times when we don't have cover and we have to make sure that we're able to hide. And the decoys can help hide you. It's a great strategy. It's worked for us many times. Another thing I do when I'm setting up a goose spread, field spread, is I'm always gonna put a few outlying geese around the main group. I'm just gonna scatter some pairs, scatter, you know, a group of four or five here and there to break up the outline of that big black mass of geese. Because when you're scouting, you look in a field, there's almost never just one group of geese. They're usually a central core and then some little scattered groups around. And in early season, I'll really break them up and make them look more like family groups. But later on in the season, you'll often see bigger bunches together. And then there's always a few geese that just don't want to join the party, and they're kind of scattered around. And I always make sure that my spread looks like that to some degree. And then one other thing that's worked great for me is to leave a landing hole, but to put two geese decoys in the middle of the landing hole. And I like a nice high head gander and like another goose, like with the neck outstretched honking. Looks like they just landed there. And the other geese oftentimes will just key on those two decoys in the middle of the hole. And it's a great way to kind of draw their attention right to that spot and look like a couple geese have already landed in front of them. We've got kind of the decoys in two bunches. So we got one big bunch upwind here, and then we've got another smaller bunch downwind, and then a hole right here. So, all right guys, tip number five, blinds. This is super critical because the geese are very pressured now. Lots of people are hunting them and they are used to looking for blinds. I always take the vegetation that I've used to brush in my blinds off on every hunt, remove it, and then get fresh stuff for the new hunt. Because the vegetation that you will find in one field may be completely different than what you're finding in the next field. Even in the same type of field, it could be wet one day, dry another, and your blinds just aren't going to blend in as well if you don't have that fresh, you know, greenery and stuff, whatever you're using to brush that blind in. If you can see them, the geese can see them. One other little tip for you is to be creative with the blinds. Again, we can put decoys around them, try and hide them that way. And we even have actually taken bales of straw out in the field and spread like two bales of straw out to make it look like just a big mass of grass, and then brush the blinds in with grass when there was like literally no cover and it was like a parking lot. And it worked. The geese just saw that big giant patch of grass and straw, and they didn't really realize that it was individual blinds. It kind of broke up the outline. So just make sure that you're using your head and making sure you use the natural vegetation, and change that out every single time that you use those blinds. All right guys, I got one final tip here for you. This is my favorite one. Before I give you this tip, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel. I've got lots of other good goose hunting and fishing content on here. And leave a comment down below if you've got more tips. I wanna hear from you guys on all your tips, and I'm sure you can help all of the viewers on this video learn some more. And maybe we can do a follow-up video at some point too. So, tip number six. This one is basically when you've got everything set up the way you want it, your decoys are right, your blinds are right, you've done your scouting, everything's looking good. The last thing I do before we settle into the blinds is communicate with my hunters. This one I learned from guiding. You can't over communicate. You want those guys to know exactly what's gonna happen when those geese come in. So you want to explain, okay, you guys on the left, when these birds come in, you're going to shoot the birds on the left hand side of the flock. Guys in the middle, you're shooting the middle. Guys on the right, you're shooting the right. I'm going to be calling the shots. Don't shoot, don't do anything until I say go. And just explain kind of what's going to happen on that hunt. And then everybody's on the same page. There's not going to be any hurt feelings. Everybody is going to be happy. And then we're gonna probably harvest more birds more efficiently, etc., etc. So make sure that you have a game plan and a flight plan before you go ahead and sit down in those blinds. All right guys, that's six tips. Hopefully those helped you out a lot, and you can go put them to use next time you're out in the field goose hunting. See you next time.